Thank you for joining us at St. Joseph's Church, Takapuna, for Mass. Today is the 27th Sunday of Ordinary Time in the Church's liturgical year. It's also a day of remembering the dignity and wonder of life. Our priest celebrant is Father Mark Napa, with Monsignor David Tonks con-celebrating. God works hard and generously to provide for creation and all it holds, entrusting the care of all things to human beings. Sadly, some entrusted with caring forget the one who has given them responsibility. They even try to eliminate the messengers sent by God to call them back to right living. But in the end, God will triumph. Let's join in our gathering hymn.
By name, Lord. matua, o te tamaiti, o te waiowatapu.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, let us acknowledge our need for God's mercy and forgiveness, for our God is a God of love and tenderness. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Almighty and ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us, to pardon what conscience dreads, and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Let me sing for my beloved my love song concerning his vineyard. My beloved had a vineyard on a very fertile hill. He dug it and cleared it of stones and planted it with choice vines. He built a watchtower in the midst of it and hewed out a wine vat in it. He expected it to yield grapes, but it yielded wild grapes. And now, inhabitants of Jerusalem and people of Judah, judge between me and my vineyard. What more was there to do for my vineyard that I have not done in it? When I expected it to yield grapes, why did it yield wild grapes? And now I will tell you what I will do to my vineyard. I will remove its hedge, and it shall be devoured. I will break down its wall, and it shall be trampled down. I will make it a waste. It shall not be pruned or hoed, and it shall be overgrown with briars and thorns. I will also command the clouds that they rain no rain upon it. For the vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel, and the people of Judah are his pleasant planting. He expected justice, but saw bloodshed, righteousness, but heard a cry. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel.
And we shall never forsake you again. Give us life that we may call upon your name. God of hosts, bring us back. Let your face shine on us, and we shall be saved.
The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians. Do not worry about anything, but in everything let your requests be made known to God by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence and if there's anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O
Lord. Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "Listen to another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a fence around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a watchtower. Then he leased it to tenants and went to another country. When the harvest time had come, he sent his slaves to the tenants to collect his produce. But the tenants seized his slaves, beat one, killed another, and stoned another. Again, he sent other slaves, more than the first. They treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, saying, 'They will respect my son.' But when the tenants saw the son, they said to themselves, 'This is the heir. Come, let's kill him and get his inheritance.' So they seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. Now, when the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants?" They said to him, "He will put those wretches to a miserable death and lease the vineyard to other tenants who will give him the produce at the harvest time." Jesus said to them, Have you never read in the scriptures, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone? This was the Lord's work, and it is amazing in our eyes. Therefore, I tell you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that produces the fruits of the kingdom. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, God is reminding us today that all good things in life have come from Him. We often get angry at God and ask why He allows bad things to happen. However, we often do not ask ourselves a much more important question, and that is, why do good things happen? Where did it come from? Today's readings paint the picture of a vineyard or a garden. Gardens are environments carefully created by gardeners in order to enable plants to be healthy and reach maturity and bear abundant fruit later on. God is a gardener who sees our souls as gardens of virtues. Just as God supplied the vineyard with air, sunlight, water, soil, the wall to protect it, and the tower to guard it, so God supplies each one of us with life, talents, opportunities, families, sacraments, faith, knowledge, conscience, and the guidance of the church. There is no good thing we can think of that does not owe its origin and existence to God. And one of the very best things that God gives us is His mercy and His patience. Today's readings show how many chances God gives His tenants to do the right thing, to fulfill their duties, to do what they were put there to do. When they don't do what's right, the landlord sends three different messengers, including his own son. In justice, however, he did not have to send any. He could have evicted those selfish stewards right away. But like the landlord, God is patient with us, patient with our sins, stubbornness of heart, and our selfishness. He keeps giving us more and more chances, many more than we deserve. God never gives up on us, even though sometimes we give up on ourselves. God's boundless mercy is the best evidence of His immense goodness. The Hollywood blockbuster movie, The Passion of the Christ, uses a brilliant artistic license to illustrate this limitlessness of God's overflowing goodness and mercy. It is interesting to note that in the film, Jesus actually says the line that converts the good thief, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." Jesus in that film mentions that twice. Once from the cross, and once while they were nailing Him to the cross. When Mel Gibson was asked why he had Jesus saying it twice, when the Gospels mention it only once, He answered that he thought Jesus was probably saying it the whole time. My dear sisters and brothers, God's mercy and goodness is always ready to come into our lives. Always. We just have to open the door of our hearts. Let us all profess our living faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Nourished by the Word of God and strengthened by the Holy Spirit, we come before the Lord, bringing to him all our needs.
For the grace to remember that we are tenants of God's vineyard and stewards of creation, never forgetting that the owner is God, from whom all blessings flow. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit will guide us as we prepare for the general election, that we may choose leaders dedicated to human welfare and to the common good of our country. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis and the Church representatives gathered in Rome for the Synod on Synodality, that the Holy Spirit will be with them as they pray and work to enrich the mission of the Church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who cultivate the earth, vineyard workers, farmers, vegetable and fruit growers, that their work may help feed humanity while nurturing the future of our environment. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, the frail elderly, and the housebound, that they may gain strength in their struggles by looking to Jesus, the crucified one. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this Respect Life Day of Prayer may lead us to appreciate the gift of life in all forms of creation, earth, plants, animals, and humans, and to work for the respect of life, especially in the unborn, the vulnerable, and the voiceless. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For students and staff returning to school this week, that the final term may be a time of happy learning and human growth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for Ukraine.
Gracious God, in overflowing love, you breathe forth life, and the human family was created. We turn to you in urgent prayer, because your children, brothers and sisters of each other, are at war in too many parts of your creation. We bring before you especially the situation in Ukraine. May the Spirit open the eyes and the hearts of leaders to the plight of the wounded, the tears of the homeless, and the devastation of bombs. May the Spirit soften attitudes
and inspire a solution that is reconciling, just and peaceful. May Mary, whose heart is immaculate, unite the hearts of our Russian and Ukrainian children in the quest for peace. And Lord, make us instruments of your peace, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Loving Father, send your Holy Spirit and strengthen us with your grace, so that we may be good stewards of your gifts, especially your creation. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name,
for our good and the good of all His holy Church. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world, that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Stephen, our Bishop, Patrick, our Bishop Emeritus, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Joseph, her husband, with the apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
To him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Sheila and Graham are going to bring the communion to the sick. Graham and Sheila, may God bless your generous hearts in serving our dear brothers and sisters who are sick. Send them our love and our prayers, and may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, everyone, and have a blessed day.